opponents. He needs the right names. He needs William Cepeda. Look, he's a tremendous, tremendous talent.
Shakur is currently a free agent caught between two potential futures, one with Mayweather and the other with Oscar De La Hoya.
One of the best top three guys out there, seriously, in the world. And he's still young.
Players are eager to sign Shakur, creating so much tension that Floyd and De La Hoya nearly found themselves in a confrontation.
Their vision. Look, I promoted Mayweather 15 fights, 16 fights. And so there's kind of like a blueprint there.
Oceans, led by Oscar De La Hoya and founded in 2002, has been a major force in boxing. Over the years, it has earned millions and showcased elite talents in the sport. Notably, Floyd Mayweather benefited from De La Hoya's vision, with Golden Boy Promotions supporting him during his rise to greatness.
Give me a call. Would love to make a fight with you.
He made a statement. That's the bottom line.
Drawing inspiration from his past successes, De La Hoya has recently focused on Shakur Stevenson, unveiling a significant opportunity for the 27-year-old boxer. In an exclusive interview, the 51-year-old promoter shared his insights on Stevenson's potential. I promoted Floyd Mayweather for 15 fights, so there's a kind of blueprint. He needs opponents, the right names, and he needs William Zappos.
We saw with William with Pitbull, where he took him the distance, so I think this win for Cepeda was excellent, and now we go for the win.
However, Stevenson's future largely depends on what De La Hoya can offer and what Stevenson envisions for himself. Fresh off a decision win against Artem Harut Union on July 6, Stevenson faces a crucial decision. His contract with Top Rank under the legendary promoter Bob Arum ended the same night as his victory, making him a free agent.
Right now, this is exclusive. William Cepeda will fight Shakur Stevenson. He will fight Shakur. I will make that fight next if Shakur calls.
Now, as a sought-after free agent, Stevenson is exploring his options. Promotions like Mayweather Promotions and Matchroom Boxing have shown keen interest in signing the young sensation. De La Hoya is also in the mix, trying to attract Stevenson by highlighting how he helped elevate Mayweather to fame by matching him against top-tier opponents.
So much Floyd, whereas like certain things he's telling me to do, I already done seen it before. Like I done seen him do it. I understand exactly what he's saying, so it kind of clicked to me fast.
Currently, Stevenson is set to attend a Matchroom Boxing event on Saturday, July 13th, featuring IBF welterweight champion Jurrin Ennis. This appearance has sparked speculation about Stevenson's future. Could it indicate he is leaning towards joining Eddie Hearn's camp at Matchroom Boxing?
Against anybody right now, Shakur. The only one is Shakur. Shakur. He's a bad motherfucker. He's a bad.
Stevenson is not fighting. His presence at the event has fueled rumors about his potential move to Matchroom Boxing. After a somewhat tumultuous relationship with Top Rank, it appears Stevenson has no plans to re-sign with Bob Arum's promotion.
If he wants to pledge his future, then you make a significant investment. If it's a 2-3 fight deal, then he's going to be getting a lot of money and it's got to work for you as well.
Stevenson is evaluating his future, considering both Mayweather Promotions and Matchroom Boxing. Each promotion offers distinct advantages. Mayweather Promotions has a boutique approach, focusing on a core group of 10 to 25 fighters, allowing for personalized attention and development. On the other hand, Eddie Hearn's Matchroom Boxing boasts a roster of high-profile fighters like Anthony Joshua, Katie Taylor, Dmitry Bivol, Jurrin Ennis, and Jesse Rodriguez, providing significant star.
But like with Floyd, it's not just offense, it was like defensive stuff and a lot of things where it's like that could work for me. So it's like normal stuff, like stuff that my grandfather do. I'll tell you a little something. It was like a pick stick.
Mayweather Promotions, however, needs a star like Shakur Stevenson to rejuvenate its brand. Aside from Kerbal Mon, the promotion lacks a big name capable of attracting significant attention and revenue. Signing Stevenson could provide the boost needed to restore Mayweather Promotions' prominence in the boxing world. Stevenson has been careful not to show his hand too early, praising both Mayweather and Hearn for their impressive track records and the opportunities they could offer. He has expressed admiration for Mayweather's achievements and his ability to build global boxing stars. This balanced approach suggests Stevenson is thoughtfully weighing his options to find the best fit for his aspirations.
Nah, it was amazing working with Floyd. you know, it was amazing to see his reflexes still sharp. I was testing his conditioning while we was on the mitts.
Oscar De La Hoya and Floyd Mayweather are not backing down, both competing to secure the same fighter. The tension between these two boxing legends has escalated, making physical confrontation inevitable. De La Hoya has always been direct and has openly criticized Mayweather and his promotional company. In a recent interview, he stated that Floyd only uses fighters for his own fame, questioning the current status of those Mayweather has promoted. He also accused Floyd's business dealings of being unreliable, claiming he makes grand promises to fighters but delivers nothing substantial. These comments did not sit well with Mayweather, who is known for his pride and strong defense of his legacy. The undefeated champion is sensitive to criticism, especially regarding his business ventures. Although Mayweather promotions may not be as big as some competitors, Floyd takes immense pride in them, viewing them as an extension of his successful career and proof of his business acumen. The tension escalated when Mayweather could no longer tolerate De La Hoya's trash talk and confronted him.
The latest news with you was you got in a little work with Floyd Mayweather. You posted the pictures. I saw your buddy Keyshawn Davis. He posted a little bit of footage. I know you posted a little footage too, but not really the footage we wanted to see. You know, we was hoping to see you on the mitts too, but
this follows Mayweather's desire to sign Stevenson. Speaking on a popular sports podcast, he highlighted his interest in bringing Stevenson into his stable, noting Stevenson's eagerness to face top competition. Mayweather also acknowledged the upcoming end of Stevenson's contract and expressed optimism about the potential.
The biggest puncher, I feel, at the 135 would probably be Gervonta Tank Davis.
Mm-hmm.
But the most skillful fighter at 135 will be hands down Shakur Stevens.
Stevenson wants to fight the best, asking if he can compete at that level. With his contract nearing its end, he hopes to collaborate with Mayweather to reach the next stage in his career and secure the fights he desires. Mayweather's pitch reflects his commitment to advancing Stevenson's career by providing high-caliber matchups. This aligns with Stevenson's ambition to challenge top contenders in his weight class, suggesting a potential synergy between fighter and promoter. Joining Mayweather Promotions not only represents a strategic career move for Stevenson, but also offers the chance to leverage Mayweather's extensive experience and influence in boxing.
I believe his contract is coming to an end, so hopefully we can come together and I can take him to that next level and give him the fights that he need, that he want, and make the fights happen that he want.
Shakur's recent Zoom call with Oscar De La Hoya of Golden Boy Promotions marks a crucial decision point in his career. De La Hoya, a seasoned promoter and former multi-time world champion, expressed optimism about signing Stevenson, stating, "I believe there's absolutely an opportunity to sign Stevenson." He emphasized that it depends on what he can offer Stevenson and the fighters on their roster. Drawing parallels to his past with Floyd Mayweather, De La Hoya noted the importance of securing the right opponents to elevate Stevenson's career. He pointed out William Zappa, a highly ranked lightweight under Golden Boy, as a potential matchup, highlighting Zappa's knockout power and recent third-round victory over Gavin Cabrera as evidence of his potential as a formidable challenger in the lightweight division, aligning with De La Hoya's strategy to enhance Stevenson's profile.
Contra Shakur Stevenson, creo que mi estilo de pelea y el estilo que él tiene sería una muy buena pelea. Sabemos que Shakur es un poquito limitado en no arriesgar en las peleas.
Following their discussion, De La Hoya took to social media to suggest a potential collaboration, noting a productive meeting with Stevenson's representatives. He stated that William Zappa would only fight Stevenson if Shakur joined Golden Boy Promotions. De La Hoya made his intentions clear, expressing a strong desire to secure Stevenson's signature and praising his talent. "He's a great fighter, and I would love to work with him." Drawing from his experience promoting Mayweather, De La Hoya emphasized his role in orchestrating key matchups that defined Mayweather's career.
William Zepeda with the third round stoppage on Giovanni Cabrera. We on the roll. I told y'all Cabrera ain't got nothing for Zepeda. Zepeda broke him down.
The prospect of Mayweather Promotions entering the fray adds complexity to Stevenson's decision-making process, led by Richard Scher. Despite being smaller in scale, Mayweather Promotions takes a boutique approach, focusing on a select group of fighters while carrying the prestige of Floyd Mayweather, a global boxing icon. Comparisons between Stevenson and Mayweather have surfaced due to their technical skills and quick movements in the ring. Additionally, Mayweather's transition from a skilled boxer to a controversial figure known for his wealth and bold personality parallels Stevenson's evolving public image.
Shakur is trying to do the same thing. He want to fight the best they got out there. He's asking, can he fight the best?
Criticism has emerged regarding Stevenson's recent performances, which some fans view as overly defensive and lacking excitement. De La Hoya referenced this critique, suggesting that Stevenson needs dynamic opponents like Zappa to fully showcase his potential and regain fan interest. Meanwhile, negotiations between lightweight champion Gervonta Tank Davis and Vasyl Lomachenko to unify titles have intensified, further influencing Stevenson's decision-making. With Davis and Lomachenko as key figures in the division, Stevenson faces the challenge of choosing a promoter who can navigate these competitive dynamics and advance his career.
Kind of that's that old school knowledge, like when you mentioned your grandfather and everything. That's rare. Like that's that little special thing that a lot of other fighters coming up.
Formerly promoted by Bob Arum's Top Rank, Stevenson's departure marks a new chapter in his professional journey. Arum's focus on developing new prospects like Denis Berinchik highlights the shifting priorities within Top Rank, prompting Stevenson to carefully evaluate his options. De La Hoya acknowledged the complexities in determining Stevenson's market value and fit for Golden Boy, stating, "I'm not sure what his market value is, and that's what makes it a little difficult." He emphasized the importance of Stevenson's decision to prioritize fan engagement and career advancement. De La Hoya advised Stevenson to assess his recent performances and set realistic career goals. Take a look at your last 3 to 4 fights and put a realistic value on that. Be honest and ask, what am I really worth?